All right, we're sitting here working on the zone system, and the call was they wasn't getting no air downstairs when the thermostat calls. Starts to blow upstairs, and then it fades out, and then they get air from nowhere. And this, let me see here, fix this light. All right, I see this Honeywell damper here, and they got one over there. That's downstairs, that's upstairs. Now these are reversible, where you can take the motor and put it directly on the other side on the shaft and make it the opposite of what it is power closed on one side and it's powered open if you put it on the other side. Well, somebody installed these and wired them up wrong. One has to be powered open and one of them has to be powered closed. This one is powered closed, this one's powered open. As you can see, there's a light back there now. Because that one has to be powered open. And they had it both. This one was working. That one was not. So all I had to do, since they have this zone board, you can use, as you can see right here, power open and power closed for one damper. This is powered open. I had to wire. That's the one that was power closed, and this is power closed. But I had to set this one to power open. That's the issue. So it's been wrong from the day it was put in. Maybe not the wiring here, because this is probably both of the dampers that originally was here was actually power open. But when they changed them, they try to flip it or whatever, they did something wrong, because one has to be powered open and one power closed. So somebody's switched the motor from one side to the other, but they didn't wire it properly on the board to match the dampers they put in, because these dampers can't be that old. This is the ones that I use when I put in zone systems or replace dampers. But we got air now. Now we're going to go shut the whole thing down, turn on just nothing but the downstairs, and be sure we get air, which I do believe we will, because it was doing it a while ago, but I just want to do it by thermostat just to check out the system completely. And then I got to tape up the hole there, and I got to tape up the hole here, because this is one that feeds downstairs, and now I'm actually getting air. My thermostat downstairs is actually on. And they said this board was replaced about 2-3 years ago. But I just don't know how long it's been this way, because it was wired wrong. I don't know how it got that way, but it should be fixed now. I'll go test it and see. Right, we got air here. So now we're gonna shut it down. Mode, heat, nope, don't need it. Turn it off. It should start closing. Yep, just slowly but surely. All right, let's go check downstairs. Saw that we turn off the thermostat upstairs, which is this one, and you see it says closed. But this one over here for downstairs has been reversed to the other side, and it says it's closed, but it's actually open because the motor has been put on the opposite side, and that's why both of them say closed, even though that one over there is actually open, because it's been, the motor's been flipped to the other side for some reason. That one's been flipped because this is the way they come. They come power closed. And that one's powered open. That one's been changed for some reason. But just a little bit of rewiring. As you can see the damper here. Let's see if I can get light so you can actually see. As you can see, this one is on power closed. And that's the way they were when I got here. And I had to change that one. That's the only thing I found. The damper was opening and closing as I was putting power to it. But I didn't know that that motor over there was actually flipped. So I cut a hole into the flex, and when it says it was open, it actually wasn't. And that's when I realized it was been flipped. So I rewired this zone board and it fixed the problem. I wish they all this easy, but whoever installed it, and there's no telling how long it's been this way. When this damper over here was put in, it looks like the original. I don't know if it is or not, but if it is, it's always been that way. Strange mysteries that never be known, I guess. But let's button this bad boy up, put some tape on the hole here. Well, I come out here and this is what I'm getting. From the outdoor unit, compressor is humming, fan is not running either. So let's check the capacitor, check the motor and all that good stuff. Zone board wired wrong or something, all screwy up there. It wasn't done right. So let's see what we find here. See if the motor is frozen up by any chance. Freely spin. Yeah, so there's no issue there. So maybe we caught it before the compressor overheated and we have to cool it. Might be just a capacitor. Let's find out. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we have found an issue. As you can see that it's kind of swollen a little bit. So we need a 45 and a 7.5. So let's go see if we got one on the truck, change this bad boy out, and hopefully the fan and compressor will fire up. Let's see what happens. Well, we got the new capacitor in, and come find out the motor is gone, which don't surprise me because there's no telling how long this capacitor's been weak and been putting the stress on the motor, and it's gone. And I called Train and the warranty is gone on it. Nobody actually registered the unit, so the 5 years is up. So, and Train does not have the motor in stock, so I'm gonna go to another supply house and see if they have one that will match the specs. And hopefully you'll find one somewhere today and get this thing up and running. Customer came out and actually started talking, so I didn't film actually putting in the new motor and the capacitor and mounting the blade and all that. The motor I put in took a 5.0 capacitor, so I had to put a single 5.0 because the other motor took a 7.5. But it's up and running. Got to get back to the office and send them a bill. But I'm on the way to another one that says the outdoor unit is not running. The last time I worked on this was about 3 years ago, and it was low on charge. And I fixed the leak, pressure test, vacuumed. Didn't show no signs of any leaks, so there's no telling what it is. It might be another leak, but you'll see that in another video.